Potholes have become the bane of existence for many Memphis drivers, an ever-present problem the city has tried to tackle. But could artificial intelligence be part of the solution?
No one wants to hit a big one.
No.
WRD investigators take a closer look at the new technology the city is using and what else they hope it can do. Our chief investigator, Jessica Gertler, explains why some drivers are thrilled to see it.
A dream in the making. For Quincy Wadley.
I always wanted to cook.
Since launching Fry Guy's food truck 6 years ago, he's battled some bumps in the road. Literally.
Potholes are very bad.
Wadley says lately it feels like an obstacle course as he drives throughout the city. He says he's avoided problems until recently when a semi-truck kicked up debris in a pothole, chipping his windshield.
And they just fill the potholes up with the little rocks and they come right back up.
Unfortunately, potholes have become a Memphis staple.
There were some that were very deep.
Drivers telling us they dodged them in every neighborhood.
South Memphis.
That's pretty bad.
Yeah, some big holes.
Big holes that can cost you. AAA says repairs average around $600.
If you want to take your kids on a ride, just take them down that road. You just bump.
Stanley Evans says he jokes about it to help him cope. A pothole just damaged the front of his vehicle.
And now I have damage up under the front end, then that's a problem.
See, Memphis is spread out. There's 6,800 lane miles of city streets, and for years, efforts to pave them were underfunded. Crews rely heavily on the public to report potholes. That is, until now. Memphis Public Works Director Robert Connect.
Technology is the future, as we all know. We've been very fortunate to partner with Google Cloud and then Spring ML.
He says they're using artificial intelligence and machine learning to try to tackle the problem. Attached to a city car, you see a device they're training to efficiently and accurately identify potholes.
And it's really showing huge benefits. I get contacted by other cities like, wow, you guys are doing this cutting edge technology tool. How? You know, how can we do it?
Connect says this technology opens up a lot of doors, not just dealing with potholes like this one, but he says they're looking at maybe attaching it to a self-driving car. They're also training it to spot exterior code violations like overgrown grass. So instead of relying on the public to submit a 311 report, they would get notified and send an inspector out to take action.
Now, how far can we teach the model to reliably provide us a violation is happening at a property beyond just overgrown grass? Is there a vehicle parked on the grass? Is there a broken window? There's so many opportunities from the exterior violation standpoint that would help us.
Connect says it could help the city be more proactive with the limited staffing and resources they have, tackling challenges in a more strategic way. Plus, fewer potholes could save the city money if they don't have to pay out as many claims for the potholes not patched in a timely manner. WREG investigators requested in February the number of claims filed and how much the city has paid out. We're waiting to hear back. What we do know, drivers believe tracking and managing potholes and blight will only improve their quality of life.
They need to make it be, you know, livable for everybody.
Wadley agrees.
They bad, especially on the expressway.
Better roads only help his business. The business he's worked hard for. Investigating for your news leader, Jessica Gertler, WREG News Channel 3.